In this video, we're going to be talking about setting those big goals, Godzilla goals. We'll be discussing how you set them, how you make those baby steps, and how you get them accomplished. Coming up next. Hi, everybody. My name is Dee Burks, and this is Retirement Rescue, where we learn how to make money, save money, and live well in retirement. Well, one of the questions I get asked a lot is, how do you set those big goals? The top of the mountain, the Godzilla goals. It's not that setting those goals are hard. It's the achieving them that's really hard. But I'm going to give you a direct path on how you set those big goals, prioritize them, create the steps, and then the task lists that you will be doing every single week to get those goals accomplished. Now, this is my little Godzilla. You'll notice he has a couple of different tags on him. And the first one is my $2.5 million retirement fund goal. That's my personal goal. That's my big Godzilla goal. Now, some people think that setting big goals just sets you up for failure, but that's not true. Having some sort of vision for your life, some sort of direction, even if it's a long-range direction, gives you hope. It gives you encouragement. It gives you somewhere to go. If all your goals are little, easily achievable goals, they don't mean anything, and you don't feel like you're accomplishing anything. So setting these big visions helps you have a really incredible direction for your life, and you will accomplish much more by setting a big goal than you will by setting those little, insignificant goals that you can reach every day. Now, the first thing you need to do, if you're going to start setting these big goals, is figure out how to dream again. A lot of us have gotten so beaten down by life, especially here recently. We have focused on what's practical instead of what's possible. We think, oh, well, I'd love to have $1 million in my retirement account, but that's not really possible, so I'm just going to go along with what I'm doing now. Well, it's not going to ever be possible if you don't try. $2.5 million is big for me. I mean, big. But you know what? A big goal pushes me harder. It pushes me faster. So the first thing to do is to sit down and make a list of the top 25 things you want to accomplish in the next 5 to 10 years. Do you want to get a degree? Do you want to set up a home-based business? Do you want to quit your job and live off your investments? Do you want to do like me and have a secure retirement? Are those things that appeal to you? It's got to be something that you really, really want. Now, once you make this list of 20 to 25 items, go down that list and really think about each one of those. Because the next step, step number 2, is to prioritize that list. What do you want the most? Not the fastest. Not what you're going to get to the fastest. Don't even think about that. Not the most practical. Leave that out the window. What do you want the most? For me, I want to know my future is absolutely secure. That's what I want the most. That's what I connected with the most. That's what's first on my list. Now, then you want to go through and prioritize that list. Get you a top 10. What are the top 10 most wanted things for you for the next 10 years? Now, on my list, once I had that 10, I looked at the top 5 or 6. Those are my Godzilla goals. And you'll see this little Godzilla has 2 of them around his neck. One of them I've got turned around because it involves real estate, and we don't want to let that cat out of the bag. But the other one is my retirement fund. I put this little Godzilla where I can see it every day. When you have your big vision goals, you want to have them on a vision board. You want to have them on a whiteboard in your office. You want to have them where you see them every day. Put them as a screensaver on your computer. Don't just hide it in a file on your computer that you'll, you know, run across 5 years from now and think, oh, I didn't do any of that. I know we all do that. So don't do that. Put it somewhere you can see it. I see Godzilla every single day. He sits right near my computer up high because my dog still thinks he would make a great chew toy. So he sits up high. I see him every day. I see my big goals every day. That's important. See your vision every day. Now, once you have that top five or six that you feel really strongly about, those are your big vision goals. The next step is to think, okay, in the next 1 to 2 years, 12 to 24 months, what do I want to accomplish on those? How am I going to get from point A to those goals? What can I do in the next 2 years? And make a list of what you can do. In my case, for my retirement goals, it was create passive streams of income. I listed the various passive streams of income that I wanted to try and create. That was my next step. I want to do that in the next 2 years so those things can be building that retirement account to get to that goal in 5 to 10 years, hopefully 5 years. Now, once you have your five or six Godzilla goals and you have your list of 4 to 6 things that you're going to try to accomplish on each Godzilla goal in the next 2 years, now is when you do your task list. What are you going to do this week? This week. Give yourself weekly tasks. And these tasks can be quite small. It can be investigating how to set up an LLC for your business so you can start working from home. It can be research on, well, Skillshare versus Teachable. I just did that. I did a video on it. There's a link to it above because it's one of my passive streams of income. Whatever your goals are, create actionable steps and put a date on it. I put a date on every one of my Godzilla goals. I put a date on every one of my intermediate goals that are 12 to 24 months. I put a date for accomplishment on every one of my little tasks. And then I write down how it went. Now let's talk about writing down how it went. It is really important to track your progress because it is human nature to a year from now look back and think, oh gosh, I just didn't do anything. I'm just not anywhere where I thought I would be. Okay, why is that? Go and look and see what you accomplished or didn't. Most of the time, you will realize you accomplished way more than you think you did. It's just that it moves really slowly in those first few months. It moves really slowly, and you don't see a lot of return on that time investment. But it will happen if you keep going. And by tracking it and writing it down, you have a journal of your progress. You know, there are a lot of people I know, and I'm one of them, that keeps a written business journal of some kind. I keep a list of my tasks for each day, what I'm working on, who I'm working with, what appointments I have, and I write them down at the end of the day before. I sit and write a list. Here's what I want to do the next day. A lot of people do that. But I have notebooks that date all the way back to the late 1990s where I was doing that. I can look and see how far I have come in all those years. And it is really inspirational. Who would have thought it? And it wouldn't have happened if I didn't have some big goals. You know, I can look back at those notebooks and it's really funny because one of the goals I set for myself was I used to have goals where, oh, before I'm 30, I want this. Or before I'm 40, I want this. Yeah, I don't set them age-wise anymore. But back then, one of my big goals, because I had been a stay-at-home mom for years, and one of my big goals, I wanted to get my bachelor's degree before I turned 30. And I set that as a goal, and I set myself a little task. I ended up having to move to a different town. I was a single parent by then. It was not easy. But I focused on that goal, and I did it. And then one of my next goals was, well, I want a master's degree before I'm 35. I did that too. Was it always easy? No. But it wasn't that I attacked it all at once. I attacked it weekly, daily, with these little bitty tasks. And before you know it, those things happened. But they would never have happened if I just sat at home and said, oh, I wish. It's not about wishing and it's not about wanting. It's about doing. Now, those of you who remember Good to Great, Jim Collins, that book came out way back, a bit well-known business book. He called these big, hairy, audacious goals. And it's the same concept. I call them Godzilla goals because I connect with that. You call them whatever you want. Maybe it's the top of the mountain goals. But you have to have that vision first of where you're going and what you want to do and be before you can set these little tasks. Otherwise, you're just doing tasks toward things that aren't getting you anywhere. Now, don't get me wrong. Some people get completely lost in setting the goals and then don't do much toward the accomplishment. I get that. But the practice of setting goals and putting them where you can see them every day, not hiding them in a file. And I know a lot of people like to do stuff on the computer. They like to have an app. But honestly, in my experience, the best way to connect with your goals is to handwrite them, set them by your bed, set them on your desk at work, read them daily. That is the best way to connect with those goals. It's not hiding it in a file on your computer that you might look at. You've really got to look at them frequently. Remind yourself, this is why you're doing all this. Because every single person has the potential to change their lives dramatically just with little bitty steps they can accomplish every week. You don't have to think, oh, how am I going to get to the top of that mountain? How am I going to get to Godzilla? You just have to focus on those little tasks that you've set for yourself toward that big goal. And before you know it, that goal happens.